Debit card transactions. In this video, I'm going to show you how to accept in CurrencyXchanger a debit card as a form of payment in an invoice. So first of all, what I want to show you is how to actually set up a debit card subledger account. So we need to go into the subledger module by clicking on the icon. And across the toolbar, let's click on all. You'll see that we don't have a debit card account or a subledger account, so we need to create this. So up on the toolbar, clicking on new, we can start by putting in the account name. So we'll call this debit card. And then clicking on tab, you'll see that we need to then pick a main account. So we're going to put this as a cash account. So you can either type in cash or you can find it from the list. We can select and click pick, or we can double click. You'll see that the cash checkbox has already been checked off. We also need to check off the settlement account. That's because your debit card account will be a settlement account. It's something that will need to be settled either at the end of the day or the end of the week, and so that we need to actually settle this into our bank account at some point. Then we also need to check off display this account in the pull-down menu in invoice, and then we can click on save. You'll see that we now have a debit card subledger account. So now I can take you through a transaction. So we need to do that in our invoice module, so clicking on the invoice icon, and across the top, select new on our toolbar. Now we can do this with walk-in customers, so let's just tab down and say that someone has come in and wants to buy from us, so we're going to sell them, so sell or paid, and they're going to buy 300 euros, let's say. So going over to the right-hand side, we want to click on add row. It's just asking us for denominations, so I'm just quickly going to put 3 100 bills and then click on add line and save. And you'll see that we now need to get from the customer $388.31. The customer is going to be paying with a debit card, so let's first put received, and then we need the payment option. So clicking on the drop down, we're going to select account. We now have another drop-down to pick from, so let's go to that, and we can select debit card. This is the account we've just created, and the checkbox that we made sure that we checked was so that it would appear in that drop-down that I just showed you there. So now we need to go over to the right side and just click on add row, and it will bring you into this other field, into this other window. So you'll see that we have all the information of this transaction, but we also have this reference number field as well. What we suggest putting into here is on your transaction receipt from the actual debit machine, you'll notice there is a reference number, and it's highly recommended to put that number in here so that you can do your reconciliations correctly at the end of the day and you can match up your transactions right here. So let's click on save, and you'll see that the invoice has balanced itself out. So we've sold 300 euros to the customer, and they've paid us with a debit card, and that's been paid into our debit card account. So we can click on save, and we can print the invoice if we need to, and then I'm just going to click close. What I want to take you through now is another transaction using a debit card as a form of payment, but I'm going to show you how to add a fee to this as well. So on your toolbar, let's click on new across the top, and let's just have another walk-in customer. And let's say we sell or pay them, they would like 400 GBP. So I'm going to click tab and then click on add row. Again, it's asking for denomination, so I'm just going to quickly put in 4 100 pound notes, click on add line and save. So now what we need to do is we need to receive this into an account, so we can do receive. And again, from our select from our drop down, we need to select the account, and then that brings up the other account drop down. We can now pick the debit card account. Now we want to add a fee to this. So how do we do that? Going down to our fee field, we can select into the field and put in the amount we want to charge. So, you know, for this example, we're going to put $3. So once we put in $3, we can then go up to the payoff button. So you just need to click right here, and the system will calculate how much that is that they will now need to pay. So $653.44. And you'll see down in the local amount, $650.44 is the actual value of the 400 GBPs that we sold them. And this is the actual amount that we're going to charge them. So we've got that $3 fee added. So we simply just go over to add row one more time. And again, the field for reference number for your debit card transaction can be entered in here. And then we can click on save. You'll see that the invoice is balanced out and it's showing that we've got the fee added as well. So we can click on save, print the invoice if needed, and I'm just going to click close.